council had just planted the field with grass to provide a play area for local children. According to Hillingdon Council, the travellers smashed down a padlocked gate and broke a fence to get onto the site, even though the council had dug a deep trench to try and prevent them. Hillingdon maintained that it's just the start of the trouble and expense London councils have come to expect from travelling families as they find a place to settle for the winter.
Well, the main problem is that we have these people moving on to public open space, rapidly turning it into a filthy mess, and then moving on when presumably they find the conditions intolerable for themselves. It costs us between £15,000 and £20,000 a year. We've already spent £5,000 this year on tidying up this site after a previous illegal encampment.
But they say they're here because the council doesn't provide a site for them.
Well, that's totally untrue. We provide a site with 25 places in West Drayton, which is 10 more than we're required to do. And I would say that there is a problem that other authorities don't meet their responsibilities as we do. But it's intolerable that we should have this problem recurrently.
And it's not just in Hillingdon that the travellers are unwelcome. They've already been moved on from a site 2 miles down the road. And in East London, in Tower Hamlets and Newham, the council are blockading all open areas in an effort to keep them out.
The law is that they should accommodate, they should build a site for 15 families, but it also states they should accommodate gypsies resulting or residing to their area, which they don't do. What I'd sooner see happen up and down the country is transit sites where people can go, temporary stopping places where people can go, and have the job done properly. It's no good of just letting people come along, stick them in a field, then start having the aggravation afterwards. Let's find places for them to go, then perhaps everybody will be satisfied.
But as long as the law says local authorities are only bound to provide places for 15 families, then councils will use the law to evict the hundreds of travellers that flock to London every winter. Having won their case against the travellers in the High Court today, Hillingdon Council will instruct bailiffs to take possession of the site if the travellers refuse to move. Jane Corbin for Thames News.